Welcome. Excellent. Well, good afternoon, everybody, and thank you all for joining us. It's certainly great to look out and see so many friendly faces and people I haven't seen for a while, so certainly welcome. For those of you I have not met, though, my name is Len Eastlifson. I'm the MLA for Brandon East, and it's my pleasure to be your MC this afternoon. I'd first like to start by welcoming my colleagues, Premier Brian Pallister, Minister Cliff Cullen to Brandon today. Thank you for joining us. And our guests, also Mayor Rick Chrest, Police Chief Wayne Balcean, and Deputy Chief Randy Lewis. Thank you very much for joining us today. As we're aware, public safety is very important to our government, and that's why we're here today. We are here to announce funding for two important measures that will A, help reduce crime in the city of Brandon, and two, improve safety for the people in Brandon. But before I go any further, I'll turn the microphone and the floor over to Premier Brian Pallister. Premier.
Hi, everybody. It's great to be back in my second home, and to say best of the Christmas season to everybody that's here today, and to see my former student from Neyland who turned out so good here today, Mayor Chrest. It's nice to see you, sir. And to say to members of Bear Clan that are here, thank you so much for your efforts. They are really appreciated. Thank you so much. I'm just gonna be real quick and say all of us that are here today are friends of public safety. We believe that people deserve to live in neighborhoods that are safe. They deserve to live in places where their family feels safe and where their family feels respected. And that's what these officers, the peace officers who are here with us today, are dedicated to making sure happens. And we appreciate and thank them for their work. I know you'd like to show your thanks to the policemen that are here today too. It's that concern for public safety that seen our government focus as we must, as all of us must, with limited resources, focus them better and try to get better results from the money that we have, not just go and ask people to pay more all the time in taxes or worse, write checks on the credit cards of our kids, sign away their futures. We can't do that. We can't keep doing that. So we focused our resources, I think, better. And one of the things we focused on investing in this past year is what's called FleetNet. Some of you will know what it is, but it's an emergency communication system that our peace officers, our healthcare professionals, fire people and all use to communicate with one another when there's a disaster. And that system was, the previous government knew it was going to be out of commission years ago, but they didn't replace it. So it's about a $450 million investment. It's a big, big, expensive system, but it keeps our public safety people connected. So they're not only connected with each other, but with one another. So they're able to do a better job of being safe when they're doing the things they're doing, and also a better job of protecting us when they're doing the things they're doing. And that's really, really important, right? Because that's when we really need a policeman, we don't need an excuse. When we really need somebody that knows how to get a fire out, we don't need a reason. We need them here and we need them now. And getting that care and that protection when we need it is really, really important. Now, we in the community, though, have a lot to offer to help and to assist. I'm looking at the members of Bear Clan now because I admire what you do. And I think stepping up and helping is an important thing to do. And we have the opportunity, with this Proceeds of Crime announcement today, we have the opportunity to capture the innovation and the initiative of the people who work in our frontline protective services. This is what these programs are. I think there's about 15 applications for programs of various kinds and initiatives, and 14 approved. It's pretty good, close to $500,000. And these are ideas that come from people who work on the front line. So I say with confidence, if they come from people who work on the front line, they're good ideas. And they're ideas that'll work. And they're ideas we gotta make happen together. So today, to me, is a real good news announcement. It's something that we can all celebrate, especially this time of year, I think, as hopefully you get a chance to join together with friends and family and enjoy the company of those you love. And we always appreciate the fact that we live in a beautiful country, beautiful province, and one of the key things about it is we can live together in peace and security. And that's something we all have to work together to achieve. So thank you to all of you for being here, and thanks for everything you do in the front line to help people. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Mr. Premier. I'll now turn the floor over to Minister Cullen.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure to be here. Premier, welcome to Western Manitoba. It's so good to see you back in our communities. Chief Balcean, Deputy Chief Lewis, thank you very much for opening your doors again. It's good to see you on a regular basis, and it we really appreciate the relationships we've been able to develop over the last few months, and we appreciate, again, opening your doors for us. Mayor Chrest, always a pleasure to see you. We're looking forward to continuing the good working relationship that we have with the city. So with that, I just want to say it's an important day. We're in Brandon to announce some money all across the province today, and it's nearly $500,000 through the proceeds of crime fund to various police agencies. We recognize that Brandon has faced its challenges when we talk about the illicit drug trade here, and not just individuals in our community being impacted, but also residents are being impacted on the crime side. So I know the initiative that the city of Brandon has taken and put the applications forward, and we're certainly happy to be here to respond to those requests. So that's why we're investing more than $65,000 here in Brandon for two initiatives that we think will provide some positive outcomes for the citizens of Manitoba, and in fact, citizens of the region as well. We recognize the growing trend of bicycle thefts, and I know the police here have pointed that out, and this investment will respond to that. It will support a prevention strategy, and this funding will support the creation of a bike registry, which will be new to Brandon, and help improve secure bike parking locations throughout the city as well. We also recognize that it's very upsetting to have your property stolen, and certainly we believe these simple investments will help citizens with the tools they need to protect their property from criminals. But I think it's also important that we should remind people to make sure that they protect their property so that it's not targeted by criminals. So a message to the public that they have a role to play in this as well. Now, we are also investing funds in a strategy to help offenders who are being released from Brandon Correctional Center. So the goal is to help them find a job and help them develop the skills they need to successfully break those cycles of crime in their lives. We believe this will improve public safety for everyone. So the investment also involves important community partners, including the Brandon Neighborhood Renewal Corporation, the John Howard Society of Brandon, the Brandon Literacy Council, and the Samaritan House Employment Resource Center. So we want to thank those organizations for their commitment to the community as well. And I also want to thank the members that are here from the Citizens on Patrol and members of the Bear Clan for the great work that you do in this community. So thank you for that, and we look forward to working with you as well. And I will say, from the Bear Clan's perspective, we are announcing some considerable funding for Bear Clan as well today as part of this overall $500,000 investment. So we're really looking forward to the results that your organizations provide our communities. So in closing, thank you for the opportunity to be here today. It's an honor to be here with the Brandon Police Services to make this important announcement. I will say from the outset that with every investment, our goal is to ensure safer communities, strong partnerships with law enforcement, strong partners with other agencies, and looking for a better Manitoba overall. Today's investment is another step towards those goals. So thank you very much for joining us. I will also echo the Premier's sentiments. All the best of the season to each of you and your families. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister Cullen. I'd next like to ask Police Chief Wayne Balcean to please come up and say a few words.
First of all, thank you all very much for being here today. Premier Pallister, thank you and your government for the announcement that's coming forward today and the funding that we will be receiving to support these programs. It's muchly appreciated. And through Minister Cullen's office, criminal property forfeiture funding, both on the federal level and the provincial level, that we've been the benefactors of, is been hugely successful in Brandon. A number of the vehicles, equipment, programs, training that our officers have been able to have has simply been from the proceeds of criminal property forfeiture. And really, what better way than taking it out of criminals' hands and putting it into the good guys' hands to make sure that this program succeeds. So again, thank you all for that. MLA Len Eastlifson, thank you for your support for the Brandon Police Service. And I know that you've been involved with our police services, police board throughout the development at that time. So it's very important that we acknowledge your contributions here as well. And Mayor Chrest, again, it's always a pleasure to have you here in our office and the support that we receive from the city as a police service. So recognizing all of our community partners that are here today, John Howard Society, Bear Clan, Brandon Neighborhood Renewal Corporation, and many others, I think that's what's important is the partnerships that we're building. And such as this, I'm only left to say that the only better day than today at the Brandon Police Service will be tomorrow at the Brandon Police Service. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Chief. Prior to taking any media questions, though, I am going to ask our guests here to come up to the podium. We'll do a photo, and then from there we'll open up to the media here at the podium. So again, to everyone else, thank you very much for joining us today. Lots of exciting announcements that our government is pushing forward. And with my colleague, Reg Helwer, the MLA from Brandon West, we continue to advocate for the best interests of Brandon, but also the area right around us. So from all of us, thank you very much. Best of the season to you. And I'll ask my friends here to join us for a photo at the podium. Thank you again very much.
That'd be you. That's you and me. We'll slide over.